Hi everyone and welcome to today's video. My name is Summer and this is my brother Troy.
What's up?
Today we are back here again sharing a bunch of traveling tips. Today specifically is going to be ways to find cheap flights. So we narrowed it down to 5 different apps / resources that we personally use or have tested out ourselves that we really like and have saved us a ton of money traveling. So if you are interested in this type of video and if you enjoy this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe to my channel. We do tons of traveling videos together. We've done a Cuba traveling tips and we've also done Thailand traveling secrets. And these are things that you would only know if you actually travel to these places. So they are super helpful. If you're interested in traveling to either of those places, I will link those videos down below. And without further ado, let's get started.
Super excited. It's been a while since I've been on here with you, so we're about to do one. I think one of our passion is traveling, so
Definitely. It's
always fun to do these. So I'm like super excited because we're going to give you our very best secrets and tips to find super cheap flights, and we're going to jump right into it right here, right now, starting with the world famous Google Flights.
Well, it is world famous, right? Because everybody uses Google, and this is obviously a very well-known platform. All of you guys know this isn't a huge secret, whereas some of the ones that we will be sharing with you guys are probably more unknown or more uncommon to the average person. But obviously Google Flights, we can just start with, you know, the basic things that we know about it and the tools that we like to use when we're on the platform. So obviously it's really great for tracking flights to different destinations. They have a calendar option. So as you're looking at your different dates, it'll show you the exact price in the little calendar boxes. So you can see, oh, if I leave a day later or I come back a day earlier, it'll be a little bit cheaper. And it's great if you have flexible dates.
Flexibility is the key because that's always the number one thing when you're trying to find cheap flights is have flexible dates.
Yeah.
If you punch 2 dates in there, I want to leave on this day and return on this day, it's usually always going to be your most expensive option. So if you can leave within a day or two of each one, you're going to find the cheapest. And I love the calendar-based view, like she said, because you can literally click on the calendar and it'll show you in green what the cheapest days to fly are. And so that's super, super helpful. So I know and I can plan my trip around that. And also, I love it because it's both domestic and international. It shows almost all the airlines. I guess the only one con is it doesn't show Southwest Airlines. So you have to go to Southwest on your own.
Right.
I love their app, though. It's super easy to use. But they just don't show Southwest's flights on Google Flights.
I believe that's the only actual airline that it doesn't show, right? I'm pretty sure.
For the bigger ones, yes. It also doesn't show super small airlines that are within, let's say, Europe or Asia.
Okay.
But those different. So we have a couple apps for you later on, and we hope that you stay tuned because we're going to show you some really cool apps to find flights, and those are included there, and they're super, super cheap.
Another great thing about Google Flights is you can set price alerts, so it'll send you push notifications through email whenever your flight goes up or decreases. So that's obviously a really handy tool to have. Also, it'll show you on your home page if you plug in your home or your
airport.
Yeah, that's near you. It'll show you a bunch of destinations that are really affordable in price. So maybe you thought you wanted to go somewhere, but then you look in the destinations area and it shows you somewhere that's super affordable, probably just like a place you wanted to go, and a place that you probably never thought about going, so if you didn't see it there.
And a hot tip there is you can have up to 7 airports in your home, and so you all have to do is click the little plus button and you can add. So for us, it's Los Angeles, that's our base airport, but we also prefer to fly out of Long Beach. Santa Ana, which is Orange County. Sometimes I've even flown out of San Diego because it's cheaper, and you can add up to 7 there. And what you want to do is in your destination, leave it blank and then hit search. And when I leave in that blank, it'll show you all the flights and the cheapest flights from your home destination. So that's a tip right there if you want to find, where do I want to fly to in the world? If I'm going to go to Hawaii or whatever, and it'll show you exactly. So leave that blank, and that's a really cool tool to use.
Yes. And one other thing is you can also plug in multiple destinations. So say you're planning on traveling from LA to Beijing to Indonesia, and then all the way back. Whatever your trip looks like, you can plug in every single step along the way, and it'll actually give you a better deal if you book all your flights at once, and it'll show you all the best prices for each of those trips as well. So that's a great thing.
Yes, that's the multiple trip option. Also, what we've done also is to have Google Flights open in two different web browsers, or two different tabs, I'm sorry, and then try to do two different one-way flights. It might even be on different airlines. And sometimes when you book a one-way and a one-way, it's cheaper than booking a round trip.
True.
You're looking at different dates, different airlines. And so sometimes if you just book round trip, it tries to give you the same airline. You're like, no, I want two different airlines because they're cheaper one-ways.
Also, last thing is they offer package deals for flights and hotels to wherever you're traveling to. So that's something to look into. I personally haven't booked a package deal through them, but I see it pop up all the time. They show you all the hotels that are in the area that you're going. So that's another awesome amenity that they give as well.
And the price alerts go straight to your inbox. So put your email in, your best email, and they'll send you automatic price alerts.
Exactly. Okay, so the second app that we are going to talk about, but I'll be leading the way on this one because I use this app a ton, is called Hopper. So I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard about this app. It's great for tracking prices for anywhere that you want to go in the world. And kind of similar to Google Flights, there are a few airlines that they don't include. So Southwest, once again, isn't on this app. That's the only one that I know for certain isn't on it, but like we said, just go to that actual airline if you want to book through them. So I'm going to start a screen recording so I can show you guys exactly how I use this app because it is very handy. So I'm going to go to Hopper in my phone and I'm going to click on flights and I'm going to put in my home base is LA, so LAX, and I'm going to put in Ibiza. Because I feel like that's a popular destination people want to go.
I took a pill.
Yeah, exactly. So as you can see at the top, it already breaks the calendar down into four different colors. Green obviously means that's the best price you're going to get. Red, worst price. So if I were to be wanting to go next week, obviously October would not be a good time to go. It's completely red in the month of October. And as I scroll down, you can see it's pretty scattered throughout, but it gives you a feel of what months are the best time to travel there. So I'm just going to click on March because that's a popular time to travel, spring break. And I'm going to do the 3rd through the 10th. So it already says at the top that since it's in green, it should be about $625 or more per person. So then it takes you to the next page and it's showing me the current lowest price is $744 per traveler, which is 100 more than it showed in the actual calendar. So as you can see, sometimes this might be a little bit off. And another thing that you definitely want to look at is the price that it initially shows you is the price with stops or layovers. So I want to hit exclude long layovers. You might not, but just for the purpose of this, I'm going to do it. So as you can see in the bottom part of the screen, it says don't want to wait. Flights with short layovers cost an extra $70. So it tells you right away how much your flight is going to increase if you put in that you don't want any layovers or stops. So that bumps up the price to $814. And then if you notice right under the little bunny, it says you should book now. So it'll tell you explicitly if you should book now or if you should wait. And that's what I really love about the app. And it's never been wrong. I've probably used this app to book flights at least 5 times, I want to say, and it's always been right on point with its tracking. When it's said it's going to go up, it's going to go up. When it's set, it's told me to wait, I've waited. And sometimes it is a little bit scary and does give me a little bit of anxiety because the price of a flight will seem really high and you don't think it'll ever go down. But based on their tracking, they're very good at determining whether the flight is actually going to go down. And like I said, it's always happened. So it says you should book now. If you're not ready to buy, watch for deals. You could save $31 per ticket. So they're saying there is a chance you could save, but probably not. You should probably book now. It's the best price you're going to get. So I'm going to click on watch this trip. And now I'm automatically watching this trip and I will get push notifications to my not to my email through the app on my phone. So unlike Google Flights, since Google Flights isn't an app, and Hopper is an actual app that you can download to your phone, the app will send me push notifications all the time when the flight increases, decreases, when I should buy, so on and so forth. So I love this app, especially for the calendar use of it. And as you could see from the very beginning of the video, it does show you hotels as well, similar to Google Flights, but I've never used that amenity. So definitely download Hopper. It's very user friendly. And like I said, it will never steer you wrong.
Based on my limited use of it, I like the calendar view where it shows you the color coded for each date, because then you can also look 4 to 5 months in advance all on one screen. Whereas any other one of these, you can't do that. You might be able to see 1 month at a time, but it's not color coded the way that Hopper is.
Right. I mean, for me, I'm a visual learner, so being able to see those different colors, it just breaks it down right away. Whereas Google Flights, it does show you the exact price on whatever day you toggle over, but it's not giving you that color coding, so you can easily just scroll through when you're looking at your destination and be like, okay, boom, these months are terrible to travel wherever you're thinking of going, and these months are great. So even if you're thinking about traveling a year later, it's great to look at the price predictions right now, because you're like, okay, these are the prices, these are the months when the prices are going to be low next year as well.
Okay, so the third one on our list, which is personally probably my favorite, And it's a little bit getting more well known actually as I talk to more people, and it's Momondo. M-O-M, like mom, and then O-N-D-O, Momondo. And this is the one that I used to book our round trip flights to Thailand. Mm-hmm. And then Summer just used it to book her flight to Dubai. Mm-hmm. And one of the reasons I love Momondo is because it's more of an international flight search than Google Flights. I feel like Google Flights is such a big company that they use bigger online travel agencies, while Momondo uses smaller ones because they're looking all over the world. And so what I did was, we were looking to go to Thailand and Philippines, and I was like, okay, well, let's fly into Bangkok, because that's centralized, it's gonna be our best bet. And so I waited, and I was looking at Momondo, was giving me good, and I was looking on Google Flights, and then one day Momondo gave me an alert that said that we could fly to Bangkok for $4.99 round trip from LA. And I was like, that's unheard of. A smoking hot deal. I gotta book that right now. So I immediately bought 3 tickets. And Momondo, and I love it too, because they also show you bar graphs when you're looking at certain dates. It'll show you what the price fluctuation looks like per week based on the date that you have set in there right now. And then you can do the same. You can get push notifications from their app, or you can get it sent to your email address. So you can get two basically for the price of one there. Momondo is completely free anyway. But that's what I really love about it. And it seems to have the cheapest flights, at least internationally, that I've been able to find.
Yeah, I think it's great for international flights for sure. And I think it's, like you said, it's still up and coming and not too many people know about it. But I think that's because it is better to use for when you're flying out of the country, not when you're staying local somewhere.
Right. And then Momondo was really clutch, was that they are also super good at inter-country flights when you're in other countries. Mm-hmm. So for example, I booked all of our, when we were in the Philippines, we have to fly into Manila, but then from Manila, we had to fly over to the other islands. And so I used Momondo because Momondo knows all those other countries out there. So like the little tiny airlines, like the Air Asia and the ones that fly from Thailand and Phuket to the Philippines and all the ones in Europe. Like, they always have those inter-country flights where you can fly to like one city to another within that country, and they're super cheap. Right. Usually like $20 or $30. Like, it's ridiculously cheap.
Right. And I think we flew on one of those, a tiny, tiny jet too, when we were...
Oh yeah, the planes were so small. The only thing to take into consideration there is when you do fly those tiny planes is that they're probably going to hit you for baggage fees, which they hit us for.
Yes, they did.
And so that's just a little bit extra research that you have to do. But if you want, like, sometimes that's your only choice, and so you're just going to have to do it. But the flights are so cheap that we did have to pay bag fees, but luckily all we had was our carry-on bags, so they weren't too heavy. But we did get dinged with those, but just the availability that comes up of those flights and the time, you're like all throughout the day.
So like you said, we got a killer deal when we flew to Thailand and the Philippines, $4.99 round trip, which is amazing from LA to Asia. And then I just booked my round trip to Dubai, and I got mine for about $875 round trip, and that's a 16-hour flight. That's
non-stop.
Yeah, on Emirates, which is the best from what I've heard. I'll probably make a video on that. But the best airline to fly internationally, so I'm very excited to see what all that hype is about. But once again, it was spot on with the tracking. It told me, you know, you got to book right now. And if I would have waited even 2 days later, it shot up over $1,000. And he actually sent me
I sent you a screenshot. Price. You were out of town. I sent you a screenshot. It went down to like
$820 something.
$828. And I missed it. At least not getting any lower than that. I'm talking nonstop round trip to Dubai on Emirates.
Yeah.
And you were out of town or something and you had to wait till you got back. But luckily, because then it went up over 900. Then it came back down.
Yeah, then it came back down. Yeah, and I was worried, but they were on point again with the tracking. And that does include baggage as well. It might be different for whatever airline you're flying. But on top of that, I did buy, and Momondo does help you with all these extra fees. I got just a miscellaneous charge through the airlines, and then I bought travel insurance for $50, and then I got baggage insurance, which was only $10. And what I really liked, they didn't do this when he booked for Asia, which was weird, but when I booked through Momondo, it took you to another website, right?
It includes links in there to the actual websites where you actually have to book the flight, and they're probably going to be links that you've never heard of. But just trust them, because all the ones that we've used, they've been legit. There's just ones that you probably never heard of, and it'll say, you know, book here, and you click on it, it'll take you to some other website to book, but we've had no issue.
So that's what I was going to say. So it took me, I don't remember if it was the actual Emirates website or what website. No, it wasn't. It was some website I had never heard of.
Yeah, it's going to be a separate OTA, which is an online travel agency.
Yeah, so I booked through there, but then it gave me a little message at the end that it wasn't completely confirmed yet until I got a phone call from a Momondo representative. And this is something that he didn't have to do, but I did. So I was a little bit worried about this because I was like, did this happen to you? So if that happens to you, don't worry. A representative called me within 30 minutes just to confirm all my info, my address, my name, where I'm traveling to, my dates. And then from there, I added on my baggage insurance and my other insurances as well. So it's definitely reliable. It might seem a little sketchy at first, but it's
because they're probably overseas agencies that you're booking with. So just do things a little bit different than here in America. But tell them what the price is to Dubai, like, regularly.
I think it's over. I mean, from LA, I think it's well over $1,000 normally.
Mm-hmm.
And the best I could have got, I mean, I only started looking 3 months before the trip. I'm going in November. And the best price was $820 from when I started looking till when I booked. And then after that, like I said, it shot up. I think it's at $1,200 now or something ridiculous. And that's just for your basic economy. So, all right, you guys. So we have 2 apps/resources left for you guys. And these are 2 that we're really excited to share because they are definitely the most underutilized.
Unknown.
Undiscovered. All these great things. Let me turn this real quick. And I've personally used one of them before, but Troy, I don't think had heard about either of them.
You told me about Scott's, but I'd never heard of the one that we're about to talk about. Mm-hmm. And
I've actually used
maybe
that
a couple
one.
Months ago. Okay.
Never used the last one. So let's get right into the first one. So the first one is called Skip Lagged. And I really like the whole concept behind Skip Lagged. It's a little bit hard to understand how it works. We kind of had to discuss together.
We were a little confused at first, and then but when she showed me a photograph or a diagram, I should say, that she's about to show you
right here,
then I was able to figure out and say, okay, this is how they operate. This is how they're able to give you good deals.
These great deals. It makes sense. So can you kind of explain how it works?
And I thought it was funny because it said, don't do this too often because you'll piss off the airlines.
Right. You'll understand.
So with the diagram, so basically what you're doing is skip lag is you're buying a ticket that other people are buying a two-way ticket. So basically they're buying a destination from A to C with a stop at B. And you're also purchasing A to C, but you're getting off at B. So you're getting the same price because sometimes when there's a stop at B and you're going to C, it's cheaper than going from A to C if you're willing to take that stop at B. So what you're doing is you're actually going to hop on that first leg with all those people and you're paying the same price as them, the cheaper price. But you're actually going to get off the plane at B when the rest of them are staying on and going to C. So that's basically what they're doing. And they're offering you A to B for the price of A to C, if that makes sense.
And you're not showing up to the B to C portion. So that's why we're saying that it's said to be kind of like careful because you'll piss off airlines that these seats, although you did purchase it with your money, they're now empty on the flights because you're not using the B2C leg. Right. You're only using the A to B leg.
Right. It's going to be an empty seat, basically. So let's say, for instance, let's say we're in LA and we want to go to Miami, but there's a stop in Dallas halfway. So we are going to book from LA to Dallas, but everybody else on our flight is going to be going from LA to Miami, because what SkipLag does is they're going to sell us a ticket from LA to Miami with a stop in Dallas, but we're actually gonna get off in Dallas and not even go to Miami. But on our ticket, it's not gonna show Miami either because we're getting off at Dallas, if that makes sense.
Yeah, so it's very confusing, but basically it does all the work for you. So if you download the app, I think they have a desktop version too, all you have to do is put in your home base to where you wanna go. So like you just said, if you're in LA, you're gonna put LAX to Houston, and what it's gonna do is it's gonna find you that whatever great price, and it doesn't even tell you if there's another portion of the leg.
You don't even know about the B2C. They're not telling you. That's just what the concept is that they describe on the website. That's what the diagram shows you. So you actually don't even know yourself. It's just that seat's going to be empty on the second leg of that flight, which is fine. So that's basically the premise and concept of it.
Yes.
So basically, so SkipLag, it's cool because it's going to offer you that cheaper price and you're going to hop off and you're not going to have to stop anywhere from your A to B destination. So a couple things to know about here is that when you go to their website and you start to scroll down at the bottom, they're going to advertise these really, really super cheap deals. And when you click on it, it's going to be a destination. So you're going to click on it, but you have to just know that those are one-way tickets. So that's what they advertise on their main page, is one-way flights. Mm-hmm. So just be careful. And then the other thing is, when you actually go through SkipLag and you book a round-trip flight, be very careful, because they're going to give you probably two different options. You're either going to get book a round-trip flight, but then on 90% of your flights that you book on SkipLag, if it's a round trip flight, you're going to have to book actually two separate one-way tickets, and they're going to give you two links. Mm-hmm. So it's a little bit different because of how they do their A to C, B to C different transactions. Right. Because of all those different algorithms that they use, you're going to have to book it actually two different from two different links.
Right. So you can purchase a round trip flight. You just cannot purchase them, actually check out at the same time, because they're two separate tickets.
Right. So two separate checkouts, even though it's actually a round trip flight. Because what you're not seeing is that there's actually another leg on both of those flights that you're not going to be traveling on. So you can't book a round-trip flight, because technically it's not a round-trip flight, but it's coming up as a round-trip flight, but you have to book two separate. So it's a little confusing. Just trust it, because it works.
Mm-hmm.
That is just how it works. And it's a little bit odd. It's a little bit out there, but that's how you're getting the better price. And so just be careful and basically read the small print and make sure that you're booking everything and that you're clicking on those links to make sure that you got all your bases covered.
Yeah, so essentially it's just hidden city flights. That's all that it is, and that's how they offer you that really great deal. I know it's a little bit confusing. It's a lot to take in. So if you have any questions about this app, leave them down below. We'd be happy to answer, because I know I was really confused at first, but the diagram does help a lot, because it's like you can actually visualize, okay, this is where I'm getting off and this is where I would be getting off if I was booking the whole leg of the trip, which you're not. So that's how you get the good price.
Exactly.
All right, so the last resource, because I don't think they have an app, that we're going to be talking about is called Scott's. So I originally heard about Scott's Cheap Flights from my mom, who overheard about it from some people at her church one day. This woman who was helping out one day said she got this ridiculously cheap flight to Fiji. It was unheard of. And the way that she got that was she used Scott's Cheap Flights, and she had a premium account. And sometimes when you have a premium account, you get these mistake fares, they call it. So sometimes airlines will post mistake fares, and people will be able to, if you act right away, will be able to purchase those mistake fare prices. So that is one huge thing that Scott's does that I don't think any other apps or resources really do. I think this is the only one. But unlike all the other apps that we've talked about, Scott's does offer a free side of their company, but there's also fees included if you do want the premium account where you can find these mistake fares and stuff like that. So we did a little trial run. Troy signed up for it. They had like a 14-day trial,
was it? I think it's either 10 or 14 days you get for free. So I signed up for it. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to keep it because it's only $49 a year. And I think it's worth it to get all their emails that they send you. So basically, Scotch Cheap Flights, how they work is they don't get referral fees from Google Flights or from anything else. But what they do is they're basically like an information company. They're just going to give you the information and they make money off their membership fees. So what they do is you give them your home base and you can choose multiple home bases. So for me, I chose LA and I chose San Diego because those are the two largest airports. Now they don't do, it's not, they're not going to send you, hey, here's the best flight from here to Phoenix or here to Dallas or whatever. It's basically all international flights as far as what I've gotten for the premium. So what they do is they take your home base and then they search all around the internet, all around the globe for great prices. And then they send you, let's say they find one to Fiji or to Bangkok. And I've already got a couple here. So the first one they sent me on my premium account when I signed up was from LA to Bangkok. And what they do is they say LA to Bangkok in this month is currently priced at this. And then they send you the pre-filled link to Google Flights. So they pre-fill it for you. So all I have to do is click on the link and it already fill all the information. It'll say LA to Bangkok and it'll give you a date. And then you can click on the calendar with the calendar-based view. It'll show you all the greens and it'll say, this is a spectacular deal on this date because you're saving X amount of money from what it normally would be. And they've all have been really legit. So basically LA to Bangkok with one stop in Tokyo was $479, which was even a little bit cheaper than the $499 that we booked. So I had to sign up for premium to get that alert. Now, it might not be the exact date you want to travel, but if you're flexible and you like traveling across the globe, Scotch Cheap Flights is going to send you those deals from LA, from San Diego, wherever you are. And you can't even put in a specific destination. It's going to send you whatever they find on the internet that's good at that specific time, if that makes sense.
So you're not utilizing this app for plugging in places that you want to go with specific dates and specific destinations.
It's not an app. You have to go to their website.
Exactly. This resource.
Yeah.
It's actually the complete opposite. So they're just going to send you a bunch of stuff, a bunch of destinations. And if you happen to be available at that time or it's somewhere you actually really want to go, or maybe it's somewhere you never thought about going, but you're like, wow, this is a really great price, then it's a great resource to use for people who want to travel or have the luxury to travel whenever they want and have a lot of places that on their bucket list that they would like to go.
If you are spontaneous and you want to go to exotic places, then Scotch Cheap Flights is going to send you those. Because the second email they sent me was to the Cook Islands, which is off the coast of New Zealand, Australia. And they sent me a nonstop round trip to Cook Islands from LA for $641. Now, if you've ever looked up flights to Australia, they're like $1,000 round trip. But to the Cook Islands, now it gives you the dates that are available for that. So it's not going to be like, you can just go in and like, I want to go on this date, it's going to be, it's like, if you book it on this date, it's going to be this price.
Right.
And so that's what they pre-fill and send to you. And so $641 nonstop on Air New Zealand. And the third one they sent me was from LAX to London, which had, which was also nonstop, British Airways, and that was $394 from LA.
Stop.
So, yeah, we're
what?
Exactly. And those are only those are the first year they sent me. They've sent me more since then. They've sent me places that I don't even know where the heck they are. It's like, if you want to go here, click on this, and they send you straight to Google Flights. They also send you sometimes links to Skyscanner, which is another website. And then I literally clicked on the link every single time, and it was exactly what they said it was. And these are the prices that were straight from the link that they sent me to Google Flights.
But I think I did remember seeing somewhere on the website that if you don't book within a certain amount of time, that obviously those prices are subject to change.
They're going
to
fluctuate. That's just how
so
the airlines
have to
are.
Act fast,
yeah, they tell you that straight up. They're like, these are subject to change. Like, it's not a permanent fee. Like, you can't go in a week later and want that price. It's like, no, this is what it's going to be right now. Because Scotch, they don't control the price. They're just telling you the price is this much to go this on this destination on this date.
And they might also be sending you mistake fares, which obviously you're going to change right away once the airlines finds out about it. Like that London one, I feel like it might be a mistake one because I know I've been to London and I'm going to say you can't get round trip for cheaper than 600. So $394
round trip. For LA to London. Yeah.
That's insane.
Yeah, it was ridiculous. Like, I wanted to book these immediately. But I just,
do that
yeah,
too.
I just couldn't go on the dates they were offering. And, like, there's other places we want to go to. But,
yeah.
And the other thing is they also, okay, Scotch Cheap Flights, they also have some of the best and most informative travel guide articles that I've seen out there.
Mm-hmm.
So if you just go to their website, you go to the article section or travel guidelines, and they'll give you tips on how to book travel, how to use Google Flights, how to use all these other apps. They have really, really, really good informative articles on there. So just go check out the website if nothing else.
And they do claim that pretty much all the flights that they send you are either nonstop or single stop, which is awesome. And they also claim that all of the flights are 40 to 90% off the normal price of a flight for that destination. So
I'm a believer.
I mean, yeah, from just signing up for it, and that was, what, a couple weeks ago, we wanted to see what it was truly about, and now I can see how that woman got that Fiji deal for a ridiculous price. I don't remember what it was, but I want to say it was, like, four something, which
doesn't surprise me. That might be a little cheap, but it wouldn't surprise me if it was, like, $500 or $600.
Could have been a mistake fare, you know?
Yeah, you never know.
And you can also cancel at any time, which is awesome, so.
It's a yearly fee, so it's not like you're charging me per month.
Yeah.
But to me, it's worth it just to see, even if I don't book any of them, I mean, $50.
Just to see what's out there. And do keep in mind what we're talking about. Most of these you're going to get only through the premium, so you are going to have to pay that, but it's $50 a year. I mean, if you're traveling all the time, what's $50, you know?
Exactly.
It's nothing. And you're going to save that $50 by using them, you know?
Yeah, you're going to save hundreds.
More than that, so it's definitely worth it.
All right, so I think let's finish it off here with just a couple in general traveling tips that we want to leave you guys with. And I think the first one is to stay flexible. Mm-hmm. The more flexible your dates are, the cheaper the prices are going
to
be.
Because it's definitely cheaper to travel certain days, you know, than other days. So.
Yeah, exactly. If you're locked into those dates, it's going to be more expensive. Number two, always check multiple airports to depart from. Now, if you're in larger cities like LA, we have multiple airports here, so it's better for us, but always check multiple because it might be cheaper to fly to San Diego than it is to LA. And I've done that where I've taken that 2-hour bus ride down there on Greyhound for $12, but I save $150 on the flight out of San Diego. So that's
worth
it.
Very true.
All right, number three, two-way tickets can be better than round trip. And we've both done that, whether it's domestic or international. You know, there's two separate tickets on two separate airlines. Sometimes it's cheaper than round trip.
And you are going to do that on skip lag anyway. They just do it for you. So, but do keep in mind to use that no matter what you're using. Maybe just look at two one-ways instead of a round trip. You never know.
Yep. So, and the cheapest travel days that we know of and we've heard of and we've done research on are Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. So there's the cheapest travel days. And then the most expensive days to travel on are Fridays and Sundays. Everybody's leaving town. Everybody's coming back into town.
Right.
So just keep that in mind. And we have debunked the theory.
I was just going to say this.
That booking on Tuesdays.
Well, that there's Tuesday flight deals or flight sales.
Yeah. So that actually no longer, it's been debunked by the research we've done. And the reason is the airlines are so sophisticated now that they have algorithms that change the price hourly. And so they don't care what day of the week it is and what time it is. Like, they just have these machines that change the price. And
exactly.
Tuesdays, Wednesdays, like, it doesn't matter. But those days that you're, not that you're booked, these aren't booking days, these are actually traveling days.
Right, so
those
that you're leaving on.
Those are yes, or arriving. So those are the cheapest, most expensive days to travel on.
Right, but the booking myth that there's Tuesday seat deals is no longer. It used to be true.
Correct.
From our research, it used to, in fact, be a thing, but it's no longer anymore. So whenever you get that price alert, that push notification, and it's telling you to book right then and there.
Yep. And then from doing more research, the best time to book as far as an outlay to how far out you want to book, domestic flights, it's been anywhere from 2 to 3 months. And sometimes, and that's give or take a few days or a week, of course. And then international flights, you want to book about 3 to 5 months out. And sometimes that 3 month mark is because that's about when you did Dubai, right? Maybe even a little bit
yeah,
less.
Yeah, it was 3 months.
Yeah, so that's the sweet spot that you're going to find. And then Hopper's good for that because it can show you 3 to 5 months out. You're like, oh, okay, here's the green, here's the red.
Yeah, exactly.
And so those are our tips. Hopefully this was informative for you.
Yeah,
and we gave you some
good
info. I mean, use these and you will not be disappointed.
Yeah, if you've used any of them or if you start using them after watching this video, please let us know. I'd love to know if they helped you guys out because I know that they've helped us out a ton so far. So yeah, until our next travel video,
Any questions, hit us up. We'll be helping you guys out along the way, and hopefully we'll have more videos coming for you soon.
Yeah, more traveling vlogs and more travel tips. So yeah, all right, we'll see you guys in our next video. Bye.